Hello and welcome to the podcast of our church here at St. John's Germelo from Parish in Springvale. Today, our English edition.
We are the German Lutheran Church in Southeast Melbourne, where we also speak English, and we welcome you, wish you a good day and a blessed week.
Our topic today, John the Baptist. Please note everybody, our next podcast in English is on the 17th of July.
And we have today also an inspirational word from the Bible to encourage and strengthen, motivate and comfort, lift you up and sustain you during these coming hours and week. And we want to share with you some information about John the Baptist. But why? We chose this topic because usually we would have celebrated this next Sunday, 21st of June, Johannes Feuer, which is here at St. John's, our annual congregational celebration. And we usually celebrate this on the Sunday before St. John's special commemoration day, which is usually on the 24th of June. But because this year, because of the coronavirus pandemic, we had to postpone the Johannes Feuer, we thought we share some thoughts, some information about St. John the Baptist and about this day through our podcast. So what about St. John the Baptist, Tim?
Yes, what we know about John the Baptist's life. So the story of John the Baptist comes to us from the New Testament, particularly the Gospels, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, and from Flavius Josephus' work, who is a Roman historian. After living an ascetic life in the desert, John emerged into the lower Jordan Valley, preaching about the imminent arrival of God's judgment, and urging his followers to repent their sins and be baptized in preparation for the coming Messiah.
John the Baptist's preparatory message attracted hundreds, perhaps even thousands, of followers from Jerusalem and Judea. He made it clear that he himself was not the Messiah and foretold the coming of Jesus. One who is more powerful than I am will come after me.
Many religious scholars agree that John's subsequent baptism of Jesus in the River Jordan, described in three of the Gospels, Matthew, Mark, and Luke, and by a number of other canonical and non-canonical sources, is almost certainly a historical event.
What about his life and work? He was born somewhere in Judea to Zachariah, a priest of the order of Abia, and his wife Elizabeth, perhaps a relative of Mary, the mother of Jesus, as the Gospel of Luke tells us. His formative years were spent in the Judean desert, where monastic communities such as the Essenes and the individual hermits often educated the young in their own ideas. Around the year 30 after Christ, John attained great prominence, not as a priest, but as a prophet. He was active in the region of the Lower Jordan Valley, and through his austere camel's hair garment, was a traditional garb of the prophets, and his diet of locusts and wild honey, he represented either a strict adherence to tradition or set an example through them. He was living differently than other people, drawing attention through that to his message.
And John's followers were characterized by fasting beyond the demands of Jewish law and special prayers. John's ethical call for justice and charity in Luke 3 requires righteousness from everyone. John was courageous. He spoke up against the people and power, the establishment. John saw many Pharisees and Sadducees coming to where he was baptizing. He said to them, "You are like a nest of poisonous snakes." Later, he was executed for speaking the truth. He challenged Herod Antipas, who was the king at the time, and was put into prison.
John's main mission was to point to Jesus by saying, "I baptize you with water, but the one who is coming after me will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire." And St. John's was the one who baptized Jesus in the River Jordan as all of the Gospels tell us. And Jesus came one day with his disciples and John baptized him. So John has got an important message for us, not just pointing towards Jesus as we do through our lives and deeds, but calling us to speak up against the establishment where we see that people in power abuse their power. He encouraged us to be courageous, just like he was, and to live austere life. Perhaps that's also something certainly some people are drawn to until today.
What has this to do with our congregation? The name of our church refers to John the Baptist. The waves in our emblem symbolize the waters of John, in which Jesus was baptized by John the Baptist. The fish was a symbol of recognition among the early Christians. The letters of the Greek word for fish, ichthys, form in the Greek language an acronym for a creed that is still relevant to us today. Translated into English, it means Jesus Christ, God's Son, our Savior.
And we celebrate Johannes Feuer, his day, on the eve of the 23rd of June. It is the eve of celebration before the feast day of Saint John the Baptist. The Gospel of Luke states that John was born 6 months before Jesus. Therefore, the feast of John the Baptist was fixed on the 24th of June, which is 6 months before Christmas, according to the old Roman calculation. This feast day is one of the very few saints' days which commemorates the anniversary of the birth rather than the death. The feast of Saint John closely coincides with the June solstice, also referred to as midsummer in the northern hemisphere. The Christian holy day is fixed at 24th of June, but in most countries, festivities are mostly held the night before, on St. John's Eve, or, as in our case, the Sunday before. And for us, here in the Southern Hemisphere, that's also great news, because after this day, it means the days will get longer and not shorter, like in the Northern Hemisphere.
Very positive news.
Positive, yes. That's our information about St. John's. I would like to invite you that we close with a prayer of encouragement, prayer for this week, for you and for everything that lies ahead of you. We pray, God, source of our hope, through John the Baptist, you gave us an example of a person close to follow. We pray to you that we may draw courage from his example, to live forthrightly and love you and your people. May we live into his characteristics and may we follow you as he did. We ask this confident of your generosity and encouragement through Jesus Christ, your Son. Amen.
We are also offering worships again at our church in Springvale. At the moment, we are allowed to welcome 20 parishioners to our church. Please give the office a call and secure a seat. Please don't show up without securing a seat. For more information and details, visit our website, Facebook or Instagram. And Peter is not available from the 25th of June until the 9th of July, as he is on holidays. Have a wonderful time.
So, thank you.
And as always, thank you for listening and sharing, especially today. What an interesting story. And I learned by myself a lot, especially with interesting words, which I never heard before. And have a wonderful week with your family, friends, and loved ones. And we look forward to welcoming you again next week, this time again in German. Before we go, do you have a topic or you want to join us? Please get in contact with us. We are looking forward to getting your help and input. Bye-bye. Take care till then.
See you. Bye.